Just want to say good morning to my son, my brother, my friend, Sheffield. All right. Morning, sir. Thank you very much. So this gentleman, not Sheffield, this gentleman has been in beekeeping for 4 years now. He has 21 colonies of bees and is quite knowledgeable in his field, we're told. So let's find out if he really is knowledgeable. I hear daily ask him a question and I ask him on here.
Me ask him.
His name is Tino Wright and he's a apiarist and he's the owner of ODB Honey. Tino, morning friend. Welcome to
morning,
Smile Jamaica.
Tino.
Good morning, guys. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, I'm impressed you like the alias.
Me ask him.
Tino, why? Why did you want to get involved in this in the first place?
Okay. Actually, I grew up on a farm, and I was home one day, and my aunt, my favorite aunt, Auntie Wendy, she told me that, hey, she has a business opportunity that was introduced to us by a family friend. So the family friend and I, you know, he brought us to the farm and introduced us to beekeeping. I was like, this is a nice way to make some money, and it's nature and farming, so I decided to try it out.
Yeah.
You're an electromechanical engineer though, Tina. How do we jump from that into beekeeping?
Okay, I went to HART, International Tools, where I did 3 years electromechanical engineering. Right. And I was working, I got a job working, and it's okay, it's fun. And then farming, as I say, I grew up on a farm and I love nature, I love the farm. And beekeeping is very therapeutic and it makes money.
It's therapeutic?
Yes, it is.
Explain to me. You get stung by the bees regularly?
Yes, actually.
But
it's good for you.
To be stung by them?
It's good for you?
Yes, actually.
Why? Why?
If you're not allergic. There isn't much official data, but it's one of the few things that's actually good for arthritis. Like some places in Europe, they have bee therapy where you put on your nice fancy white suit and you go in and they will take a bee and sting you, and that's it.
Is there anything?
And you come back.
Is there anything bad that could come from a bee stinging you?
Well, some people actually have bad allergic reactions.
Okay.
Very few.
Okay.
But like with any sting, there's going to be the burning and a little itching, but eventually that will go away. And like for instance, for me, when I get stung nowadays, there's no longer any swelling or other stuff. You know, just the initial touch, and that's it.
Your skin get tough to it now.
kinda. My body adapts.
Yeah. Right. Is honey, straight honey, or you have different kinds of honey for whatever reason, or all honey is the same thing and it do the same thing?
No. There are different types of honey. For instance, like in Jamaica now, we have our honey is basically classed as multiflora. Given that we have so many different flowering plants and trees. So the bees will gather some pimento, some mango, guinep, or whatsoever, and they combine it, give you a nice fruity taste and all that stuff.
Oh, that sounds interesting.
Okay.
Sometimes I look at honey, Tino, and it will have like almost a clear look. Like me said, the honey, right. They look like it thin. And then you'll see another honey and it looks darker. Does that change the taste or just how effective it is? What makes it? What makes the color different?
Okay, depending on what the bees forage on. So during a season, like for instance, for the year, as the season progresses, the color of the honey, depending on your location, might change because it changes depending on what's blooming at the time. So what the bees forage on will determine the color and the taste and the texture of the honey.
Okay. I hope you can see me, right? Explain.
Yes.
Explain from the bee to this.
Okay, all right. Plants provide a sugary substance that's called nectar, right? The bee will go there, take up that nectar, then she will take it back to the colony, right? Now, this might sound a little bit gross. She regurgitates that, and then other bees will take it up, and they will pass it along a chain of bees, and then they deposit it in the cells, in the comb, right? Now, that nectar that is deposited in the comb is now combined with the different enzymes in the bee's gut, right? And it has a good amount of water in there. So they will use their wings and basically evaporate most of the water to get it to a moisture content of 18 or 19% or less.
Right, Tina.
Listen, so some questions are best not asked.
I was just going to say, serve me right, because we don't know. I didn't want that fulsome explanation.
Sorry.
But I'm just teasing, because you did what I asked you to do. But my point is, it is not just as simple as a bee just stand up and just over the back line you have on it. It takes work.
It's a process.
It's a process.
Yes, it does. It does.
What's happening with the bee industry now, Tino? I think more and more people are using honey. I mean, when I go into the stores, I see more and more honey being there. Is the industry, I don't want to use the word thriving, but how is it? How is the business?
It's a growing industry because since I've been in the industry, I've realized that a lot more people are getting involved, and especially on the small or micro scale. And as I say, it's a way to make money without working that hard in terms, because the bees do most of the work. Mm. And, you know, if you have a little land space or even your backyard, because surprisingly in Kingston, there are a lot of apiaries in Kingston and you will never know.
Right.
So it's something that anybody can do.
Right.
You know, just with some knowledge. Yes.
Tino, may I ask that question a while ago? I'm afraid to ask that one. You know, explain these two.
The honeycomb.
Yeah.
Okay. The honeycomb is all the honey is stored inside the honeycomb. That is the comb pack there now.
Right here. Instance,
right. Yes. Yeah. So that is the honeycomb that stores the honey. So when the bees store it in there and they seal it off, we would normally remove the top layer of that, put it in a centrifuge and extract the liquid honey, right? But that comb itself as there can be eaten as is.
So I can just take out this and just bite it?
Yes, you can. And I would advise you to try it. It's very nice. And most, especially for the ladies and other stuff, most of their skincare, hair care products and other stuff, they'll say that they have beeswax in there.
Yes. Yeah.
Right, but this is the natural, more potent stuff.
But Tina, I want to try it. But you see, they regurgitate where they let off.
No, but back up, liquor there,
it's
Tina.
Clean.
Back up, liquor there, Tina. Because a lot of the things you're saying now, the beeswax, of course, you know, it's processed and we put it in hair and on skin. But this is like the raw thing now, mega internalized.
Exactly.
Oh, gosh, my skin are got pretty.
There's a little. Tear section on the top there, Neville. You can look at it across the top.
Mash it up already.
No, I'm a tear, but may I try to get past right or so.
Right.
It's a little tear.
See, let me tear it.
It's here.
Yeah.
I tear it.
Just pinch off a piece and you just chew it up. You can swallow everything.
Well, it tastes like honey.
Exactly. And you can swallow everything because, as I say,
swallow the whole bag and thing.
No.
Not the bag.
Not
the bag. Everything except the bag.
It tastes good, man.
And that is good for both your digestive system. It'll help, you know.
Tina, I don't want to eat this thing and then the next thing, may I walk and start flying.
No.
Tina, question. So
sure.
You're supposed to eat it like I just did, or there's another reason why it's in the bag?
Nah, man, you eat it just like that. Just like that. And you can swallow everything there. Yeah, that's it. It's good.
I got to swallow everything, but if you want to see me have a new Kingston today, I mean.
Trust me. It's good. Because as I say, your skin, your hair, and everything. It's very nice. And it's all natural.
Tino, I'm impressed because you obviously know your stuff. How much bigger can you get, or you are at full capacity now?
I'm still growing because I have a full-time job as well, so I'm still growing.
What is that we're looking at?
Okay, that is the centrifuge. After we put the frames in the centrifuge, we're just filtering it out right now.
Okay.
So you have a little bit of wax particles and other stuff that, and probably pollen that might come out of frames.
Yeah.
So what I do, right, I just filter it there, and once it's settled, I close the bucket. And the bucket is only open when I'm going to bottle again.
Okay.
So it's totally natural, organic, and I really don't touch it. I leave the bees to do it.
Okay, all these are the same thing. They're just in different kinds of bottles. They all say raw liquid honey. They're all the same thing, or there are different kinds of honey, or what?
They're the same thing, but different people, based on what I've been doing so far, you know, different customers like different containers.
Okay.
Yeah. And like, for instance, the jars are mainly for the comb packs, or sometimes, you know, we do our honey and garlic.
Yeah.
So people can use some of the honey, put some garlic in there, and, you know, you just put it on top of your fridge and you use it when you have a cold, you know, a sore throat or anything like that.
Wonderful.
Okay. Great. You know your stuff, right. So very, very impressed. How you sell it, by the way? Oh, the different, is the same cost for everything or different cost for different size bottles and stuff?
All right, the seventh, that bottle that we see there now, that one is for $1,200.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I think for that one. Mm-hmm. All the small bottles are actually for $1,200.
Okay.
And the large 750 ml is for $2,700.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And the comb pack.
Yeah.
Right, the comb pack itself now is for $1,200 as well, and the jar with the honeycombs, that one is for $3,000 because that holds a lot more comb, and the wax itself is actually even more expensive than the honey. So based on that, right? Yeah.
Where did they find you, Tino? Online? Yeah. Where?
Okay, my Instagram page is odb_honey, and my email is tino.wright@gmail.com.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Or, you know, they can WhatsApp me at, you know, 876-290-4642.
Yeah. What them call you, honeyman? What them call you, honeyman? What them call you?
Some people at work will do that. Actually, a friend of mine called me honey, you know.
Oh, okay.
What? All right. Tino?
I hope it's a girlfriend of yours. Well, so. It really don't matter still, but honey man, good to see you. Congrats, thanks. Good luck, and I hope it works for you if this is what you want to do. Stay safe and God bless you and your family.
Yes.
Yeah, man.
All right, thank you very much for having me.
Yes,
see you guys over New Kingston. Tina Wright, a Puritan owner of ODB, honey.